Hey everyone, this is the Lego Batman Movie Arkham Asylum set. There's a lot of detail on the interior and there are a lot of minifigures to look at, so let's get started. The level of detail begins on the outside with texturing and changes of color. Wherever you see white, that's supposed to represent snow. The main doors at the front are kind of brick built sideways at you, and they're able to be opened up as well, so those fit in there nicely. They do use quite a few stickers, and you'll see those distributed about the place. Again, with the white up here, it's supposed to represent snow around the eaves of the place. Lots of smaller details up towards the top, mostly with tooth style pieces and a whole lot of telescopes. And there's your center dome, which comes up to a point ultimately. And then there are two wings of the place on the side, which have pretty much identical builds from the outside. They have identical primary structure, and you know they're supposed to be mirrored from side to side, but inside they're quite very different. Also, there's one part of the building that is actually a completely separate build, and that's the observation security or watchtower in the back, which is very narrow and actually pretty simple. I'm going to move that out of the way first and give you a better look at the main interior space with some figures. Let's start off on the right side and zoom into Harley Quinzel's lab, where she has a computer that she's sitting at with a custom-built chair. The screen is a flat screen, pretty thin and standing very upright. And she has some vials or bottles of various medication, I'm assuming. And in the cabinet next to her desk are a few syringes. Directly beneath her office is the laundry room with a big old box of powdered laundry detergent that just has a sticker on the front of it. And then there are two industrial strength washing machines in there with very nice looking builds. They're not very thick. There's not a whole lot of detail behind them, but just the front of them I think looks very good. Off to the side is a broom, which I think is actually supposed to represent a mop to clean the place up, because you can see that some suds are down on the ground around the drainage grate. And then here are the first two holding cells. Now each holding cell has a sticker within it that is unique to the character that's supposed to go inside. This one over here on the far right also has an additional sticker on the outside. It's very difficult to see the ones inside, but I'll try to show you each. So first for the Riddler, this one shows an outline of Batman's cowl and it just has a bunch of question marks around it. And the cell for Two-Face just has one of his old I Believe in Harvey Dent posters. Above the cells is a catwalk that spans most of the width of the building, and there are plenty of security cameras of two different sizes spanning the entire building, and those are just up against the wall above the second floor. In the center of the ground floor is the security checkpoint and scanner, and really these signs here on stickers should be facing towards the front of the building because new inmates would be coming in through there, and the idea is that they would have to stop, go through the check-in and then make it through. However, they point these towards you so that you can see them, but if you want to make it a little bit more realistic in its layout, you can just take the whole thing and turn it around that way. This is very convenient that you can take this out because it allows you to have a look at a nice little feature they have built into this. To demonstrate it, I have the Joker loaded in and I'm just going to pass him through the scanner and you get the X-ray view right there. And then you can just pass them the rest of the way and you supposedly don't see it anymore. The other side also works, but you'll want to turn the figure around for this to be accurate. Two floors up in the center of the building is the ward room, which doesn't have a whole lot of space for figures to fit in there, but fortunately the furniture can be removed very easily. Each of these sub-assemblies is attached by just one single stud, so I can bring this out. That's a safe that can also be seen as a staff locker, and it has security camera footage, just some tapes up on the top. This also has doors around the other side, and then this can be removed if you want to just, kind of expand your play, move some things around to different areas, or add some of your own structure. It just makes it convenient, although I don't know if this is really intended to come out like this. They may have just used the single stud for each so that they can be angled in the corners. All right, let's move to the other side. More security cameras. The catwalk continues over here. Wow, he just teleported. And then there are two more cells down here. Now, one of the cells is for the Joker. Obviously, he's still going through check-in over here. So let me open this up, and I'll open the other one as well to try to get you a view of their specialized stickers. Well, this is tough to capture, but there's a Batman movie poster on the wall for the Joker, and he has put a big Joker smile over it. Meanwhile, Poison Ivy has a poster for the movie The Plant Monster, which features a depiction of the collectible minifigure series character of the same name. Also around the front, you may have noticed that Poison Ivy's cell has some vines growing out of it. At this far end of the building is the visitation room, which has just enough space for one visitor and one inmate to speak to each other through the wall, through the window, with the help of the two handsets there. And down below is the mess hall, which has all kinds of details I'll need to show you separate from the building by pulling all of this out carefully. A whole lot went into this food counter, including these 2x3 tiles done in medium blue, which can be used to hold the food. There's a stack of plates over here. There are a couple of pretzels. There are some hot dogs or sausages. These are actually little watermelon slices, the printed quarter round pieces. Cheese here, a donut. They've got some orange juice and milk over on this side. So about that tower I mentioned earlier, here's that. It's built with the smallest number of the largest pieces reasonably possible, so it goes together very quickly, doesn't use up too many pieces, contributing to the parts count, and it's fairly light and hollow. I like the PA speakers on either side, and it looks good from the outside. It has nice shaping to it. Once again, little bits of suggested snow up on the top. From the back, like I said, very hollow, very empty inside, no furniture up top whatsoever. For some reason, there's a level here with some TNT crates that have been stowed away there. I don't know if that's part of a sabotage attempt coming that's gonna blow up the whole thing. That's not good, but you can use those however you want. And the back of this down at the ground floor is supposed to represent actually the inside of the yard, so prisoners would be able to access this and play some basketball there. Additional physical activities are made possible by the weight bench here and some free weights, and this is just a table that can be used for lunchtime or just hanging out and, you know, plotting escapes and stuff. All right, minifigure time. Obviously left to right, it's Joker, Riddler, Poison Ivy, and Two-Face. The male characters all have identical prints. Poison Ivy just adds a little bit of different body shape. All of the hips and legs are identical. They do come with the hands, you know, preset for each individual character, so you're not going to be able to mix them up accidentally. And every single one of these does include an alternate face on the back of the head. You can start to see a little bit of the face for Two-Face, that second one. I guess Two-Face is kind of a four-face in this case, wouldn't it be, with two additional faces. Let me show you what all of these look like. And this is not the same version of Arkham Asylum Joker as we got in the collectible minifigure series for this whole line. The blind bag version has the same torso and legs, but just different faces. So comparing the main face for that one, it's pretty much the opposite. Here's Arkham Asylum inmate Catwoman, complete with her full hood and utility belt that's been done in orange here. Dr. Quinzel, who has a patient file in her hands, that is a sticker on that piece. And then head of security for Arkham, Aaron Cash, on the right with his hook hand, which is all canonical. So look at these from the backs, and each of these, once again, include alternate faces, just different expressions, rather different expressions, and you also want to see what Catwoman looks like with that other face through her mask. Batman is in this set along with Reggae Man Robin, and Robin has a Phantom Zone projector for his tool there. It's made up with a red camera piece, and this actually doesn't have a sticker on it, the magnifying glass. That's actually an exclusive printed piece. I was surprised to see that. And it uses a trans medium blue colored crystal down for the base. Nice little build for that. The Reggae Man suit does have the very high sheen and iridescence to it. Here are the alternate faces with headgear on and with headgear off, and you also want to see their regular faces just as seen from the front with none of that stuff getting in the way. Finally, here are the last three figures, all representing the GCPD with Barbara Gordon on the left, and then two generic GCPD officers who don't have names in this set. They don't have any prints on their left arms, but the right arms have prints for those two officers on the right. No alternate face for the guy on the right, obviously. Alternate face for Barbara Gordon, of course, and an alternate face for this one in the middle. The last thing I have to show you is this GCPD squad car, built up in medium blue as the main color, including those fender pieces on the sides. Those are nice. These doors are double high and they can open, and there is an opening trunk in the back that can store just a couple of small accessories. So it's actually pretty full right now with just an extra walkie-talkie radio unit and a pair of handcuffs down there. I think you can put another pair of handcuffs in here and maybe, see, even with this not completely flat, it's not quite working. So maybe you can find some sort of configuration that'll allow more stuff to fit in there, but I wasn't able to find such a thing. This door can open as well. You can kind of adjust the angles of the mirrors if you want to. To get access to the interior, you want to lift the roof from the center. There are no studs there, so this just pops up very easily. Leave the tiles there. You can take one of the tiles off if you want to get even easier access to the interior. They put in some tiles in dark orange just to spruce it up a little bit to make it not look too plain. And this just has a center-mounted steering wheel and no console or anything. So there are a lot of things to like about this set, but I want to specifically highlight the value. The price to part ratio is really good, but when you consider how many of those parts go into minifigures, 12 minifigures in this set, that makes it a phenomenal value in my opinion. And even moving past the objective stuff a little bit, just look at this volume of stuff, my favorite measure of value in a set. There's a lot here. You could just see it. Unfortunately, this set does suffer from a classic LEGO structure set problem. That is, room to actually pose minifigs. They do give you enough room at least to put minifigs along the catwalk up here, but the rooms, like this room up here at the top, you know, you can put maybe two figures in there if you really squeeze them. Quinzel's office maybe can fit two people in there. At least the laundry area is big and it's on the ground, so you can kind of spill folks off the edges. The top of this observation tower is another one that's really constrained as well. Also, check this out. Let's say I want to move this whole main building over to the left, just, you know, an inch or so. So I just grab it and pull. Wait a minute. Pull. Wait a minute. Okay, so this is made in three separate sections. And they're kind of aligned, but they're not really connected. I wish they had just included axle pins to actually connect down here at the base instead of just having a little axle to kind of line it up, because any kind of movement of this thing, and I had this problem throughout the review, anytime I kind of touched the building, started to see those axles come apart. So it's really not connected. The major sections aren't connected very well, or at all, really. Also, there's no easy way to rearrange these three sections to make them come together nice and flat. Like there's no resting area, there's no landing area there where these want to become a nice, you know, just straight front of the building. The sections on the sides here use wedge plates, so if you do want to bring this together and have it just be flat on the back, then you need to take some parts out and do some custom work yourself. One last thing. A car of this size, especially with these doors, should be able to have two figures side by side. And even the official LEGO description for this set says you should be able to put three figures in here, quote unquote, easily. And you can't, not without customizing it and adding your own parts. Don't worry though, the flaws are not nearly bad enough on this set for me to recommend against it. There's just too much good stuff with the details and the playability on the interior where you can make up your own scenarios. Plus, they have a great selection of figures. In my opinion, this is another successful set from LEGO, and I think that most of this will actually work outside of the context of the LEGO Batman movie in particular, because all the characters are real anyway, so you can continue to use this once that movie is kind of forgotten about. So there you have it. I did it. I made it through this long review, and you made it through this long review as well. Thank you for that. I appreciate your time. I hope that I showed you everything you wanted to see within and about this set. If you would like to say anything about it yourself from your own perspective with your own thoughts, please share a comment down below. And if you want to see more videos from me, keep coming back to my channel because more content is always on the way. I'm going to keep working, and I'll talk to you again soon.